Hello, my name is Janet, and today we are going to do a tutorial on Pixar based on this edit. So we're going to learn how to put the circles, the color things on circles, make it black and white. And yeah, this was requested, so here we go. First, you need to open up the app Pixart. Then you'll go to edit, select your image, and we are going to start off by making the little circle thing. So you'll go to selection, and then you will get the ellipse tool, and you will select the area you want as a circle, and you will save it to Clipsart. You will keep repeating this until you're done getting all the images. So again, we're going to choose our picture, we're going to go to selection, and then we are going to use the ellipse tool, and then we're going to save to Clipsart. And again, you're going to keep repeating this until you have saved all the clip arts. Also remember that the red area is the clip art, so that's what you're going to be saving in case you have it reversed. And yeah, so once you are done with all the circle motions, you're going to add your image by going to edit, adding image, and then you are going to go to clip art, and then go to my clip art and select your first little circle. You're going to place it wherever you belong, shrink it if you need to, and you're just gonna keep doing that until all the things are placed. And yeah, so we're gonna just keep placing them. And then once you finish placing the last circle, be sure to know that once you place it, you cannot move it. So make sure you place everything the way you want it. And then we are going to adjust our tools, and then adjust, and then we are going to go to saturation, and I am going to make the picture black and white, and then I'm just going to upload the brightness, or put up the brightness a little bit to make it look nicer. And after we're done with this, we are going to go to the draw, and then we are going to draw the little lines to make it, the little lines that go there. We're going to make sure the tool, we're going to click on the first brush and then make it small, and then we're going to start drawing as straight as possible. I made my line white, so you can make your line white or however color you want, and make your line straighter than I did. So just use the erase tool if you mess up. But my lines weren't all that straight. If you could make your lines straighter, then that's awesome. And if you don't want the lines, don't add the lines. But I'm adding the lines because it was part of the requested tutorial. So then I'm going to select the color of the little shape, and then you go to shapes, and then you make sure it's stroke, not filled. So you go to stroke, and then you make the thickness as thick as you want, possibly thicker than how I wanted it or thinner than what I wanted. And then you're just going to kind of place it around the circle as best as you can. You just keep adjusting it until you place it the best you can. And if you mess up and you don't want that color or the color lays, just know that you, as long as you're on a layer, you could just erase it using the erase tool. I did not know that until I actually tried it out. But yeah, you could erase if you mess up or anything. And then you just continue to add the little circles, the shapes, onto the things as best as you can. You just kind of place it on there. So we're just going to keep placing them until we're done with that. And I forgot to mention that I did actually make a new layer to avoid any type of problem, just in case I want to erase any overlappings. So just make sure to make a new layer before you start the shape circles, so you could erase the bottom layer and not erase the top layer or any stuff. It's always best to make new layers while you're editing, especially if you have the layers, always use them. Just a little tip. Thank you. are done with draw and done with using that feature, you press the little check mark and you'll exit. And I noticed I had a little black line I did not like, so I decided to go crop it out. So you just go to tools and crop, and then I noticed a little dot there and decided to fix it using the clone tool. So again, you go to tools and you go to clone. You'll wanna, it's a little odd to use, but you'll want to move the little circular thing to an area you want to clone, and then you could kind of draw it. So you just tap on the area you want and you could draw it over it. It may take some time to get used to, but you can. And also it's better to lower the brush so it could be a little bit easier to use. So yeah, we're pretty much done. After this, we're going to add text on it. So you'll want to exit out PixArt, unless you want to use the PixArt text. But I like using Fonto because you could add your own text and stuff, your own fonts. So you'll just go to the camera roll and you'll choose the picture. You just edit it. You could add filters if you want. And we will come here. And we are using the font Baby Doll. And we're adding love. We're going to add text. We're adding a background. We'll click black. And the background is there. But you go to size and you can make it bigger if you want. And you could tilt it using the tilt area. And just tap and it says tilt. Or say, and you tap it and it says make it bigger, and then it's size. You'll tap it, and then it's a style, and you could add the background and all the style you want. I want to change the text, so I'm going to add true to it. And after a while, I kind of just start realizing it doesn't really look that great. But if you want to do it that style, you want the little black bars on the eyes, you could do that. You could tilt it however you want, and then you could overlap it. Just tap the font or the text that you want to overlap, and you can. And then you could remove it if you want. You just select them and you could remove it if you don't like the way it looks. And then you could try again and fix any errors that you want. And then you go back, you could make it the text smaller, place it wherever you want. Go to style or not, and then go to stroke, add a stroke, and then you can make the stroke as thick as you want. And then you'll just kind of place it wherever you want, as I did. And then you're done, unless you want to keep editing. And you could just keep editing, you could keep filtering and do whatever you want. And this is it. I think this type of edit will look really great if you do a family tree or something like that. I don't know, just an idea. But yeah, you're pretty much done. And yeah, all the information is below. Here is where we are done with another PixArt tutorial, and I guess I'll see you next time. I don't know when I'll do another tutorial, but I eventually will. All the links are below, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.